Get up, come and get down with the sickness. Get up, come and get down with the sickness. Get up, come and get down with the sickness.
A customer came in with a 2012 Toyota Highlander and wasn't happy with the stereo volume and clarity, so we added an Alpine 4-channel F300. It's an AB switching amp, nice sounding amp, and just to give him that extra volume and clarity for his factory system. And it turned out really bitchin'.
Need that amp that I've been asking for 30 minutes. Actually, it's been like 3 hours.
Someone blasted me, bro. Blasted my schnozzleberry with ass.
You got ass blasted in your schnozzleberry?
That's foul. Not like the bird.
That's a big word.
I have this very amp in my car. This very one.
What's going on now?
Funny.
Funny.
Boring.
Jenny.
Funny. Boring. Funny.
Uh-oh.
Boring.
What?
Oh, Jenny!
Whoa!
What is going on? Do they ever shut up?
I almost did the most dumbest thing ever.
What?
Let's tell all the folks at home. If you can see, I strategically marked these with dots. And then I almost just cut them off to where I don't know which one is what. I've done it before and I've kicked myself in the rectum a couple times.
Rectum!
Rectum damn near killed him.
You stole my line. You stole it right out of my...
Whose line is it anyway?
Can't snap like a turtle.
One more.
I'm not a turtle.
Why are you stopping working? Why are you stopping?
I have temporarily mislocated my crimpers.
Mislocated. I'll be generous and let him borrow the good crimpers.
Fish bubble.
You know what I was really hoping for is a thank you, Doug. You're very nice to let me use your crimpers.
You think I'm gonna do that on camera?
I don't think you would do it off camera. So why would you do it on camera?
And a little trick known to installers is to run more wires than you need. You gain time as far as if you have to take the car apart again for one wire. So when you're doing a aftermarket amplifier in a factory system, it's good to have an amp that has a high level built in. What you do is you run two sets of four speaker wires up to the head unit, and the four coming out of the head unit would be your signal that goes into your high level, and then you can grab your speaker leads straight to your aftermarket amp in the same spot. So you have to make sure you get your polarities right and your balance and fade, because it's a mother effort to go back track when you do high level, and that's why you label the wires.
Look at that screen. That's legit.
Okay.
Here for your backup camera. Touch screen.
Where did it go?
You flushed the iPad Nano? Up in here?
Type R.
Think about this fish, you gotta get all up in there.
I was like, are you really just messing with me? No.
You just blew the amp.
You just.
In the trunk, the rear of the car, you pop the trunk open. There's a big hole and there's hinges. And on those hinges are two bars that are tensioner bars. And they twist when it opens to help assist the weight of the trunk. Took those motherfuckers out. Put my port through the package tray. Now my trunk is like 5 million pounds. So I got gas shocks that were welding in place instead of the tensioner bars.
Maybe that's on top of the gas cylinder.
Really? A $650 woofer and this falls off the magnet? What the fuck is that? That's f***ing booty.
Yeah, look, you can see in the camera. Come here.
$650 woofer and this falls off the back.
Oh, really?
Good thing I'm not f***ing Sony.
You're showing them on camera with the woofer falling apart.
Dude,
that.
Thank you for calling. This call may be monitored or recorded for quality assurance purposes.
The prank call. That's funny. We haven't done that in a while. We finally did that today. I think we prank called a stereo shop, Alan Ed's in Huntington Beach. We heard through a rep that you guys watched the show, so we decided to prank call you. You probably won't even remember it, but if any of you went to Vaughn's to help someone with a Tahoe or the alarm locked his ice cream in the car and the door fell off, that was us!
Thank you for calling Alan Ed's in Huntington Beach.
Yeah, you guys put a remote start alarm in my car, and I'm at the grocery store, and I'm locked out of my car now. It won't even start.
Okay.
So what am I supposed to do here? I have groceries, I have ice cream, and I'm stuck in the parking lot.
How long ago did we do the install?
It was last week.
How long ago did we do?
It was last week on Wednesday.
Which vehicle was it?
A Chevy Tahoe. And the problem is I go in, everything's working fine. I go into the grocery store, I do all my shopping, and now I'm stuck. I'm sitting here screwed. You know, I don't know what I'm supposed to do. I have family over at my house. I have ice cream sitting here melting, and I'm on the phone with you. This is not what I wanted.
Okay, hold on just a moment.
Yeah, you guys put a remote start in my car, and I'm stuck at the grocery store.
Here at Alan Ed's in Huntington Beach?
Yes, I just explained myself to the gentleman, and the problem is I drove to the grocery store, and I did some shopping because I have family over, and I have an event happening right now. Everyone's watching movies, and I had to go get the ice cream, and now I'm stuck because the remote start alarm, and I can't start my car, and my ice cream is melting, and I have my wife and my kids waiting for me. Is there a button I can push? Is there a button?
What exactly is the car doing? I mean, I don't. When
it's
you
not
say
doing
stuck,
anything. I just told you it's not doing anything at all. I'm stuck in front of the grocery store with my ice cream.
Okay, sir, I'm trying to help you.
Okay, I apologize. I'm really stressed out right now. I'm just missing.
I understand that, and I'm trying to help you. What market? Where are you at?
Well, I'm right down the street at Vaughn's.
On Beach and
yeah,
Beach and McDonald's?
Yep.
Okay, I'll see you in a few. What color is the Tahoe?
It's a black Tahoe.
Black Tahoe? Okay,
yeah.
See you in a few.
Well, I'm just hoping, can we, you know, I was just wondering if I could push a button or something. Is it maybe something I can do? Do I have to push, like,
here? Well, I mean, basically, you should be able to get inside the car, turn the key on. There's a little switch, it's a push button switch. You should be able to turn the ignition on, press that switch, it will disable the alarm, and then you should be able to start the vehicle.
I can't even get into the car. It's locking me out. I can't even get in. It's completely locking me out of the car.
The key will not unlock the doors?
Oh, I never even thought of that. Hold on. The key's not even working. It won't even fit in the hole anymore.
That's just not possible.
I don't know if you change the doors, the locks on the handles. I don't know what you have to do to put this in, but it can't even unlock it now.
No, we don't change the locks on the handle when we do an alarm.
Let me go out there real quick.
Lock
on it. The whole door is missing on the other side. The whole door is gone.
The whole door?
The door's off. My tires are popped, too, now. I don't know what's happening. My ice cream's melted out of the bottom of the basket. It's just everywhere.
I'll see you in about 10.
Okay. Okay, thanks.